Will air taxis be tiny or huge by 2030? Meet Daniel Wiegand, CEO of the German air taxi startup Lilium. He's on a mission to bring the benefits of vertical takeoff and landing to the masses. And meet Pedro, a helicopter pilot whose world is soon to be disrupted by Daniel. I'm Simon Darling, welcome to Life in 2030. At the end of this video, I make a prediction about how huge air taxis will be by 2030 on a scale of 1 to 10. We need to look at the technology, we need to look at the companies, we need to look at whether you are going to absolutely love them or not, and we need to see if there's jobs being created. By 2030, the technical challenges of creating a vertical takeoff vehicle will be solved. Today, a loud engine and noisy rotor blades power the vertical takeoff of Pedro's helicopter. Daniel takes advantage of the progress made in motor and battery technology in the last decade, much of it driven by Elon Musk's Tesla. To enable vertical takeoff, Daniel's plane has 36 individual electric motors. They are quiet for two reasons. The rotors have a much lower tip speed ratio than a helicopter, and the engine is made of quiet electric motors rather than a noisy combustion engine. After takeoff, Daniel has designed the rotor to cleverly swivel. This thrusts the air taxi forwards. Due to advances in battery technology, Lilium's air taxis have a range of 150 miles, and one day the air taxis will fly without needing a pilot. This will free up a seat, increasing the capacity of the plane from 6 passengers to 7. Vertiports are the places where people board Daniel's air taxis. The building of enough of them by 2030 may be solved. Because helicopters are so noisy, there's few places for Pedro to take off from in city centres. In contrast, because air taxis are much quieter, vertiports will be dotted around a city, on top of offices, in parking lots, and on the water. A priority for Daniel at the moment is to get at least one vertiport per city, in a region as you see here envisaged around New York. Whilst by 2030 there'll be enough vertiports for intercity travel, inner city air taxi travel from one part of a city to another will still be limited because there won't be that many city centre sites across a city approved and built. Probably, maybe it's all gone mad and there's loads of them, but probably not. The technology needed for passengers to book a seat on Daniel's air taxis does not require any major innovation and is solved. Today, booking Pedro's helicopter can be done via an app, for example via Uber from Manhattan to JFK. To book an air taxi with Daniel, it's the same process. Here you see a passenger booking from Wall Street to downtown Philadelphia. They choose a time of departure, pay, and then follow the map to the nearby vertiport. In summary, because the technologies needed for air taxis are a mix of solved and may be solved by 2030, it suggests they'll be at the midpoint of being tiny or huge. Now we look at companies. The interesting thing here is that there are actually already some phenomenally huge startups. If there are unicorns, startup companies that have a valuation of more than $1 billion. And when there's plenty of big established companies such as United that are active, represented by an elephant here. Daniel's company, Lilium, is already a unicorn valued at more than $3 billion. It has top-notch investors, including my former boss at Skype, Nicholas Zennstrom. Daniel's passion for flying predated him founding Lilium. He started gliding aged 14 and had a pilot license before he could even drive legally. Joby is another air taxi company that is a unicorn, worth more than $7 billion. The Joby plane has 6 rotors which swivel to enable both vertical takeoff and then cruising. Its chairman is Joben Bivert, a serial entrepreneur whose inventions include the Joby GorillaPod camera stand used by so many YouTubers. In 2020, Joby took over Uber Elevate, Uber's air taxi business, and got a $75 million investment. Volocopter, based in Germany, is on its way to becoming a unicorn. It has a very different design. A wingless multicopter built for nimble inner city travel with a range of 20 miles only. And it has permits for inner city test flights in Singapore right now. It's amazing. There's plenty of multinational companies that are active, including United Airlines, Stellantis, and Tencent. Airlines are placing orders. This includes United, who are buying $1 billion worth of air taxis for the startup Archer Aviation. And manufacturing partnerships are happening to build the planes, including one agreed between Archer and Stellantis, the owners of Chrysler and Fiat. And the big companies are also investing in these startups. The Chinese tech conglomerate Tencent, for example, is a big investor in Lilium. Because there are plenty of unicorns and because multinational companies are so active, this look at companies points to air taxis being huge by 2030. If you're enjoying this, hit the subscribe button for more predictions about life in 2030. Looking at whether you are going to love using air taxis or not, we break it down by looking at what gets 5 stars or 1 star, i.e. things that people love and things that people don't love. Saving time on certain journeys will be huge and get 5 stars for air taxis. By 2030, a customer of Daniel meeting her girlfriend for dinner saves a lot of time. She books the air taxi on her phone, climbs the stairs to the vertiports on top of her building, walks straight onto her plane that 3 others are ride-sharing, takes off vertically and quietly, flies for 7 minutes with her looking down dreamily on the traffic below that she sees is moving very slowly because it's rush hour, and she lands at the vertiport and can't believe how beautiful it is with the sun setting on the horizon. After a quick walk to the restaurant, she's sitting down to dinner. A journey that would have taken more than an hour by road took her less than 30 minutes. Joby has a fantastically bold aspiration in respect to the time saving of their air taxi service. They say it like this, listen, to save 1 billion people an hour a day. That is worth a lot to a lot of people. Although I'm giving it a 5-star rating, by 2030 there won't really be a high enough density of vertiports to deliver on time savings for a huge number of people by then. Daniel's air taxi earns 4 stars for being good for the environment and sustainable. Although Pedro's helicopter is fast, it's a fossil fuel gas guzzler. By being electric, air taxis generate less greenhouse gases, particularly when the electricity used to charge them comes from renewable sources. But because air taxis need so much energy to get airborne, and by 2030 will be compared to an electric car journey, they will struggle to claim to be more fuel efficient than an equivalent electric car. Safety scores 4 stars. Although helicopters like Pedro's have a good safety record, they feel unsafe because there's only one rotor and no wings. To be allowed to fly, Daniel has to meet the same strict standards set by air regulators, such as the US Federal Aviation Authority for commercial aircraft. To meet these, air taxis like Daniel's have redundancy built in by having multiple rotors. Most have wings for emergency landing, and some will even have parachutes for the whole plane. And eventually they will avoid human error entirely by being fully autopiloted. It scores 3 stars for being affordable. Helicopters like Pedro's are unaffordable for most. Daniel prices his flights equivalent to an Uber premium journey, most likely. His maintenance costs are low due to the electric air taxis not needing an engine, and because they do a lot of quick trips per day. But building out the vertiport infrastructure will be costly. From the point of view of the amount of love travellers will be giving by 2030, it's at the high end of the scale. You're going to be really surprised on jobs. I was. If you go and type into LinkedIn jobs with some of the companies we've mentioned, like Lilium, like Joby, like Archer, you are going to find a lot of job vacancies. Some of them are for people who will be air taxi pilots and can get away with wearing these type of glasses for work. And others are just the normal jobs in all the different departments, IT, HR, marketing. Let's have a look at that. And then we get the conclusion on the whole video of how big are these air taxis going to be by 2030. Helicopter pilots like Pedro will one day be fired. On the hired side, Daniel's Lilium team has 112 job vacancies listed on LinkedIn at the time of recording. They cross multiple job functions, including in aircraft engineering, production, operations, finance, legal, and HR. It's well worth looking at LinkedIn if you're interested in getting a job in the air taxi sector. Helping you make good career decisions is a big reason why I'm doing this Life in 2030 channel. Jobs in fast-growing new sectors like air taxis are exciting and more secure than in older sectors. I was fortunate to join the e-commerce sector with eBay in its early days and have benefited ever since. Jobs in the air taxi industry are all around the world. Daniel's vacancies are not only in Germany, but also in Bangalore and Washington, D.C. Joby and Archer are headquartered in the U.S. Volocopter is in Germany. And there's the air taxi startup eHang headquartered in China, and Wisk has operations in New Zealand. you could set up some job alerts for these companies. It's easy to do on LinkedIn. And click to have a look at my Finding Great Jobs for Life in 2030 video. Because there's plenty of jobs being hired and fired, from a jobs point of view, air taxis is at the huge end of the scale. Now we've covered all four sections, I need to make a prediction overall about how big air taxis are going to be on a scale of 1 to 10. We saw that the technology is mostly solved. We saw that there's enormous amount of money going in with the unicorns and the companies. We also saw reasons to love it. The fact you can get there really quickly and it's good for the environment is a big plus. And that there's lots of jobs being created. That this leads to conclude that a prediction from 1 to 10 is that air taxis will be a 6. Join us for more predictions. There's one on lab-grown meat, there's one on home robots, and there's a load more. See you in the next video.